Good morning, dear students. In my last class, I derived an expression for electric potential due to an electric dipole. Today, in this class, let us understand a new concept, that is equipotential surface. We are familiar with plane surface, cylindrical surface, spherical surface. Then what exactly the equipotential surface? Look at the heading, equipotential surface. The name itself indicates electric potential is equal at all points on the surface, then such kind of surface are known as equipotential surface. Look at the statement. It is the surface on which electric potential remains same or constant at all points on it. Then such kind of surfaces is known as equipotential surface. Let us understand in detail. I consider a charge Q. At a certain distance R, the electric potential is V. For an example, the distance is 0.5 meter, the potential is, for example, 10 volt. At the same distance from the same charge but in different point, the electric potential is same, that is V is equal to 10 volt at the same distance, that is R is equal to 0.5 meter. From the same charge at the same distance, say R is equal to 0.5 meter, electric potential is 10 volt. Let us consider one more point. At this point, from the same charge at the same distance, that is R is equal to 0.5 meter, electric potential is 10 volt. Look at this. Consider a charge at a certain distance, that is R is equal to 0.5 meter for an example, the electric potential is 10 volt. From the same charge at the same distance, again the electric potential is 10 volt. From the same charge at the same distance but in different point, the electric potential is 10 volt, that is remains constant. From the same charge at the same distance, then also the electric potential is remains constant, that is 10 volt. If you join these points, it appears in the form of sphere. So look at this diagram. In this sphere, at all the points on it, the electric potential remains constant. So in this point, V, 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 and V, which means at all points on this surface, the value of electric potential remains constant or same, hence it is called EPS, that is equipotential surface. Then next, different shapes of equipotential surface. Let us study one by one. First one, equipotential surface for a point charge. Point charge means isolated charge, that is single charge. Look at this diagram. This figure indicates equipotential surface for a point charge which is in the form of concentric circles. We can write any number of concentric circle till the electric potential is zero. Suppose in the first equipotential surface, the electric potential is 100 volt. In the second equipotential surface, the potential may be 70 volt. For an example, In the third equipotential surface, the potential may be 50 volt. In the fourth equipotential surface, the potential may be 30 volts. Why? Because according to this relation, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R, which means as the distance increases, electric potential decreases. Here in the first equipotential surface, the electric potential is 100. Then at all the point on the same equipotential surface, the value is remains constant. That is 100 volt, 100 volt, 100 volt, 100 volt, and 100 volt. Similarly, look at the second equipotential surface, we have 70 volt. So at all point on the surface, it is same. That is 70 volt, 70 volt, and 70 volt, and 70 volt. Like this, we can write the value for each equipotential surface, which means electric potential remains constant or same at all the points on it. So these concentric spheres or equipotential surfaces for a point charge. The next one, equipotential surface for a dipole. Dipole means two equal and opposite charges. Look at the diagram. This figure indicates equipotential surface for a dipole or equipotential surface for two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance. In this case, the equipotential surface are closer in the region between two charges. Look at the diagram. These are equipotential surface, equipotential surfaces. Equipotential surfaces between any two charges, they are closer, they are closer, they are closer. Look at the diagram, they are closer. While on the other hand, they are far apart, they are well separated, they are well separated. Which means equipotential surface for a dipole, the equipotential surfaces are closer in the region between two charges. So this is the region between two charges. In this region, the equipotential surfaces are closer, closer, which indicates strong electric field or strong field region. To confirm this, I draw electric field lines. About electric field lines, we studied in the first chapter itself. Electric field lines are always originated from positive charge and terminated on negative charge. I draw electric field lines originated from positive charge and terminated on negative charge. Originated from positive charge, terminated on negative charge. Like this. Now look at the diagram. In the region between two charges, we can find many number of electric field lines, which indicates strong field region. So this region is strong field region, whereas on the other hand, we just see only we have only few number of electric field lines, that is weak field region. Then third one, equipotential surface for two equal positive charges. Look at the diagram. This figure indicates equipotential surface for two equal positive charges separated by a small distance. In this case, the equipotential surface are spread out इक्विपोटेंशियल सरफेस और स्प्रेड आउट इन द रीजन बिटवीन टू चार्जेस. इट इज एग्जैक्टली द ऑपोजिट सिचुएशन टू दिस. Here, the equipotential surface are closer in the region between the two charges, whereas here, the equipotential surfaces are spread out in the region between two charges and indicates weak field region. To confirm, again I'll write electric field lines. So in the region between two charges, we have only few number of electric field lines. So it indicates weak field region. Fourth one, equipotential surface for a uniform electric field. So this figure indicates equipotential surface for a uniform electric field. What do you mean by uniform electric field? The equally spaced parallel straight lines are said to be uniform electric field. So look at this diagram. The plane surfaces which are equidistant from one another having equal potential at all points on the surface. So this diagram represents equipotential surface for a uniform electric field. Now, by using these four steps, I am going to explain properties of equipotential surface. So, let us understand one by one. Properties of equipotential surface. Look at the first one. Two equipotential surface never be intersect each other. Look at the diagram. You can see the diagram. Look at this. No two equipotential surface never be intersect one another. What will happen if they are intersect each other? Suppose, for example, I'll write a small diagram here. Suppose two equipotential surface, they intersect like this at a single point, means at this point I will write electric field direction which are tangential to that point, which means when the two equipotential surface intersect one another at the point of intersection, there will be two electric field direction that is impossible. Therefore, two equipotential surface never be intersect each other. The first property. The next one, work done is zero in moving a test charge over an equipotential surface. Here the test charge is nothing but unit positive charge. Look at the property again. Work done is zero in moving a test charge over an equipotential surface. How can it is possible? Let us understand in detail. So I am going to consider any one equipotential surface. For example, the second one I am going to consider. Look at this, 70 volt, 70 volt is there. Say this as point B, this as point A. Potential at a point B, give a name VB. Potential at a point A, we can give a name as VA. I am going to place a test charge at a point B, that is Q naught. We need to move a test charge from point B to point A. Let us calculate work done. Work done, in order to bring a unit positive charge or test charge from B to A, that is work done in order to move a unit positive charge from B to A, is equal to charge into potential difference. So your WBA, that is work done in order to move a test charge from B to A, is equal to charge moved is Q naught into what is the potential difference? VA minus VB. Then work done is equal to Q into what is VA potential at a point A? 70. Minus potential at a point B? 70. So what you will get? Work done is equal to Q into 0. So work done is equal to 0. Look at the second property. Work done is 0 in moving a test charge or an equipotential is 0. Why? Because there is no potential difference between any two points on the surface. Look at the third property. The direction of electric field is always normal to the equipotential surface at every point, which means the direction of electric field always perpendicular to the equipotential surface at every point. Why like that? If the direction of electric field is not normal to the equipotential surface, what will happen? Let us understand by using a small diagram. I consider a rectangular equipotential surface. According to third property, the direction of electric field is always normal to the equipotential surface at every point, means that should be perpendicular, but I won't take perpendicular, I will draw on diagonal. When the direction of electric field is diagonal, if it is not perpendicular to the given surface, the direction of electric field is split into two components, horizontal component and vertical component, which means it would have non-zero component along the surface. In order to move a unit positive charge against non-zero component, work must be needed. But according to the second property, work done is zero. Why? Because there is no potential difference between any two points on the equipotential surface. Therefore, electric field or direction of electric field always normal to the equipotential surface at every point. Fourth one, equipotential surface are closer in the region of strong electric field and they farther apart in the region of weak electric field. Already I taught you that in this region the equipotential surfaces are closer, indicates strong field region, whereas here in the region between the two charges the equipotential surfaces are farther apart or well separated, indicates weak field region. That is what equipotential surface or closer in the region of strong electric field and they further apart in the region of weak electric field. So these are the properties of equipotential surface. The next concept is relation between electric field and electric potential, or derive E is equal to minus dV by dr. So in this concept we are finding the relation between electric field and electric potential. Look at this diagram. E is the electric field due to a charge Q. A and B are the two points in the electric field separated by a small displacement dr, and the test charge or unit positive charge placed at a point B. In order to move this unit positive charge, or in order to bring this unit positive charge from a point B to point A, work must be needed because there is an electrostatic force. The potential at a point A is VA, the potential at a point B is VB. Means there is a potential difference between these two points. Let dV be the potential difference between the points. To bring a unit positive charge from a point B to point A, work done is needed. So dW is the work done in moving unit positive charge from point B to A. By the definition, dV is equal to dW divided by Q naught. Why? Because we have this relation, V is equal to W by Q naught. By using this relation, by the definition, I can write like this. Why? Because potential difference is dV, potential difference between the points, and work done is dW, small amount of work done, since the displacement is very small. Here dW is work done. What is the work done? Work done is equal to force into displacement. Then the equation becomes dV is equal to force into displacement. What is the displacement we have? dr. Force into displacement divided by what is there in the denominator? Q naught. But I will write minus sign here. Why there will be a minus sign? Here the direction of electric field and the displacement are in opposite direction, which means the negative sign indicates that the direction of electric field and displacement are in opposite direction. Then F by Q naught, that is force per unit positive charge. The force experienced per unit positive charge is electric field intensity. This relation we learnt in the first chapter itself. Force experienced per unit positive charge is equal to electric field intensity, which means in the place of F divided by Q naught, I can write E. So dV is equal to minus E into dr. Again, I am going to simplify the equation for E. So it becomes E is equal to minus dV by dr. This is the final expression which gives the relation between electric field and electric potential. Here the quantity dV by dr, the quantity dV by dr is rate of change of electric potential with displacement. And it is called potential gradient. Look at this. The quantity dV by dr is rate of change of electric potential with displacement, and it is called potential gradient. So in this class we learnt what is equipotential surface and different shapes of equipotential surface, also properties of equipotential surface, and we derived relation between electric field and electric potential. In next class, we will discuss a new concepts. Until then, take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.